All right, we're going to continue what we were talking about. The second line of this John 6:63, Yohano wamianda miyampe, verse isamba, chapitre isamba, verse makumi asamba ne isatu. So, the second part says, inomianda yone samba. So, inomianda yone samba nenu amiwa. Yo yamushipiditu nebumi. I was saying that, you know, mianda. Mianda means words or problems. But in this context, really, it's words. Then Jesus said, the words I have spoken to you, or the word I'm speaking to you about, those words are spirit and they are life. So when you take the Bible, the words which are spoken down there, they are spirit and they are life. If you want to know who you are in spirit, you have to go there and read, trying to understand who you are. It presents who you are in the spirit, and then it gives you life. So, as we said before, the flesh counts for nothing, the body counts for nothing, but what counts for something is the spirit. So you need to know who you are in spirit, and you are spirit, the body is nothing. So inomianda, mianda, so the word yonesamba. Nesamba, yo nesamba. So this is the word I'm speaking. Kwisamba means to speak. Okay? Kwisamba means to sip.
Nisamba.
Yeah. Wisamba means to sip. Yo nesamba means the problem or the words I'm speaking. Yo is pointing to the words. Yonesamba, so the word I'm speaking. And I was saying that if you change, you translate literally, you find that things are really permitted. Change, some words come before and some words come after. If you compare to English, you know, mianda, these words or this problem I'm speaking, this problem I'm speaking, here say, the problem I'm speaking, this problem speaking to you, me. Yeah? I speak to you the problem. So the problem, nenu means with you. Nenu means with you. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
I'm speaking with you. I'm nesamba nenu. If I say nesamba nenu, I'm speaking with you. Okay? Nesamba nenu. I'm speaking with you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking to you. Nesamba nen, for instance. So yo yamushipiditu nebumi. The problem or the word I'm speaking to you, they are spirit and they are life. So the words, really, the few words we're retaining here the most, they come out, it's what? Which word you guys retain?
Nesamba. Spoken.
Spoken? Kwisamba. Nesamba. Nesamba means I'm speaking.
And mushipiditu.
Mushipiditu. Another word?
Mimi. No.
Bumi.
Bumi
means what?
She said bumi.
Life.
Life. Bumi means life. Bumi. Say bumi.
Boomy
means
boomy.
Life. If you think about life, it's boomy.
Boomy.
Eh? If I say my life, I will say boami, boomy.
Boami.
Boami. Boomy.
Boomy.
My life.
My.
Your life. Bobe. Boomy.
Bobe. Wait,
Bobe.
Bobe.
Boomy. Boomy. Your life. My life, boami, boomi. Your life, bobe bumi. His life or her life, bwandi bumi.
Bwandi bumi.
Bumi.
Bwani. Bambe.
Bwandi.
Bwandi.
Bwandi. Bwandi. Bumi. Let's say that in the provenance. Bwami bumi.
Bwami bumi.
Bobe bumi.
Bobe bumi.
Bwandi bumi.
Bwande bumi.
Yes. So my life, your life, her or his life. Let's go. Bwami bumi.
Bwami bumi.
Bobe bumi.
Bobe bumi.
Bwandi bumi.
Bwandi bumi.
Okay? Easy.
And
what about our lives?
Our bumi.
Bwetu bumi.
Bwetu.
Bwetu. Bwetu bumi.
Bwetu bumi.
I feel like it's very important to study all those probably the verb, all those verbs. We studied them before. Maybe we need to start reviewing those things, and then you retain well, because that's really the spoken Kiluba than word. But I would like to be full of words, being rich in words. Then you can speak, even if you don't speak, at least you understand a little bit. If somebody says bumi, bumi, and you understand that, bumi, I know that word, I heard it before, you know it's life. Mushipiditu, somebody put mushipiditu, or then you say, wow, that's spirit. I know it, big word. But if you wanna, you understand somebody say munwe. Munwe means what?
One.
Finger.
Oh.
Oh, we're losing everything, guys. Well, we have to review these things over and over. If we review, you'll never forget those things. And we can talk with grammar, we can talk with anyone who can speak the language, and then you keep it. So let's wrap everything around. We really done. So mushipiditu means spirit, upana means who gives. So upana bumi means life, okay? Mm-hmm. And then mubidi means body or flesh. And then bitupu means nothing. Very good. I love that. Inomianda, this problem or these words. Yonesamba, what I'm talking about. Nenu means with you. Nenu, with you. Amiwa means what?
Me.
Very good. Very good. Amiwa means me. And yoya mushipiditu, yoya mushipiditu nebumi, mushipiditu means spirit, and nebumi means and life. Ne means one. If I say A and B, I will say A and ne B. Or tata ne mama means daddy and mom or mommy. Yes.
Can I try to say a sentence?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. No, I'm not saying like a whole sentence, but I'm gonna mix some words up. Okay. Mushipititu.
Mushipititu.
Mushipititu. Mushipititu. Ne. Mubidi.
Mushipititu ne mubidi. Sounds good. Sounds good.
What does
Mushipititu ne mubidi means the spirit
and
the body. Mm?
Yeah.
Oh.
And the body. So mushibili is the mubili and the spirit and the body. So a human being is composed with the spirit, the soul, and
body.
And the body. So mushibili is the mubili is already something part of a human being. So we really done. So we'll say goodbye. It's a long video of almost 10 minutes. So, Lalapo. Shalapo.
Shalapo.
Thank you. Next time we'll continue and we'll talk about more Maybe. Words. All right. You had a question?
No.
All right. Bye.
Bye.